San Juan, Puerto Rico, the long-awaited federal trial of a Puerto Rico woman accused of hiring a hitman to kill her rich Canadian husband began on Thursday, and the judge warned the jury it would get at. A decade has gone by since Aurey Vasquez Rios was charged with offering a man $3 million to kill real estate developer Adam Manang. Vasquez at that point was no longer in Puerto Rico, and she was extradited 3 years ago from Spain with her 1-month-old baby after Alexi Manant. This is a murder case, Jose Ruiz, assistant U.S. district attorney, said in his opening statement. It was to collect money from him. Manang was killed September 22, 2005, at nearly midnight on a Friday, on the corner of a cobblestone street in the historic part of San Juan, the capital. He was hit in the head with an abject knife and then repeatedly stabbed. 12 hours earlier, he had told his wife he wanted a divorce, prosecutors said. That is something she didn't want, Ruiz said, adding that the cop's therapist had earlier recorded her reaction in his notes, I am not going to let you go that easy. The couple had begun dating 2 years before the killing, with Anna buying Vasquez's car, an apartment and a business in old San Juan called the Pink Skirt. A day before the wedding, they signed a prenup, with Anand's value estimated at more than $24 million and Vasquez's at nearly $62,300. If Anand died, his wife would receive $8 million. 6 months after he was killed, Vasquez sued his parents seeking $1 million in damages and $8 million from his estate. Shortly after filing the lawsuit, she left for Florence, Italy. Once there, prosecutors said she wrote emails to her family pleading for money. Defense attorney Lydie Lise Ribar rejected the allegations and told the jury that her client is innocent. She said she would prove that Vasquez had been wanting to go to Italy to study and work since 2002, and that she was living there under her real name. She was not hiding at all, Lise Ribar said, adding that the couple was a perfect match and liked to travel together. The evidence will show that Adam was in love with his wife. Among the testifying in the trial is Alex Pabone Cullen, whose nickname is the Crazy One. Prosecutors said he sold drugs at the Pink Skirt and elsewhere, and that Vasquez, her sister and a friend agreed to hire him as a hitman. They said he killed Anna and injured Vasquez to make it look like a robbery, but that he forgot to steal Anna's wallet and other belongings. Prosecutors said he then told a friend what he had done and asked him to drive by the crime scene to ensure Anna was dead. Also testifying is a man who sued for wrongful conviction after he was convicted of killing Anna and spent 8 months in jail. He was released when Pabon was charged. When a police interviewed Vasquez, she said that a tall, black man with tattoos on his forearms had attacked them. In the weeks after the murder, prosecutors said Pabon kept sending letters to Vasquez's sister with demands for money and other things. I don't give a damn if the victim's old man kept everything, they said he wrote. Lise Ribar, however, said that Pabon only mentioned the loans in the letters, and that he does not specifically ask for a payment. Meanwhile, Vasquez was thinking about moving from Italy to Israel, falsifying documents to prove she was Jewish and asking an attorney whether Israel had an extradition agreement with the U.S., prosecutors said. In June 2013, she was arrested when she flew to Spain from Italy. 2 years later, in September 2015, she was extradited to Puerto Rico. A pair of female twins that she had with a man in Italy stayed with their father. Abraham Manang, the victim's father, told the Associated Press that he is looking forward to seeing an ending to the case. Closure is something we're praying for, he said in a phone interview. 13 years is a very long time to wait for justice.